Hey everyone. Welcome back to the Riffsphere channel. In this video, we'll be setting up our shares and folders to comply with trash guides. Let's dive right in. The first thing we need to ensure is that hardlinks are enabled. Normally, this should be enabled by default. In simple terms, hardlinks allow a file to exist in multiple locations without taking up extra space. This is useful. For example, when you're seeding a completed download. To check if it's enabled, go to the Settings, then Global Share Settings, and verify that the Tunable option is enabled. If it's not enabled, don't worry. Just head over to the Main tab. Stop the array. Go back to Settings. Enable the Tunable option in Global Share Settings. Click Apply. Return to the Main tab. And start the array again. Now let's set up our share. Many guides and Docker templates recommend splitting things up. But that can break our hard links. So, we'll use just one share for our media and download directories. Go to the Shares tab and click on Add Share. I'll use the name data, but you can choose any other name. Note that I'm using all lowercase letters. You can enter any comments you want. By default, Unraid uses the array as the primary storage. However, this keeps your disks active while downloading or seeding. To avoid that, we'll use another pool as primary storage and the array as secondary. To prevent my downloads from affecting my SSDs and to have enough space, I added an old hard disk to my system. If you have fast internet, you may need to use a cheap SSD or a ZFS pool with multiple disks to keep up. Make sure the mover action is set to move from the cache to the array. And then click the Add Share button. According to trash guides, using the cache will preserve hard links. Let's verify that. I added all commands in the description so you can replicate this on your system. Move to a recently created data share and create a file. Now, let's create a link to that file. Just to be sure, let's also make a copy of the file. As a first test, let's edit the linked file. Now let's show the content of our three files. The first file was changed when we edited our linked file. Now, let's go to the cache for our share and list the files with their inodes. As you can see, the first two files have the same inode, indicating that they are indeed linked to the same data. The third file has a different inode, confirming that it's a different file. Now, let's go back to the Main tab and start the mover. Let's verify the files are indeed moved. When checking the files on our disks, we see the inodes have changed, but they still match for the linked files. Showing the content of the files still shows everything is correct. Finally, let's clean up. Now that we have our share created, let's export it. Since this is a media server guide, I won't go into different share options and security. We'll simply set the export for SMB to yes, keeping all the defaults. And click apply. With our share created, let's set up our basic file structure by going to our share. Trash guide suggests creating three folders: torrents, usenet, and media. Personally, I prefer to put the usenet and torrents folders in a download folder to keep things cleaner, especially when using other protocols to manually download files. Again, all my folder names are in lowercase. And just like that, we have our share and folders set up correctly. Thanks for watching. And remember to like and subscribe for more content.